that the Lord hath made, we shall do what? We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Psalms 118:24. We cannot, though, conjure up this type of joy within ourselves or even within our own power. It is and has to come from the one and only source, and that is the Lord. And that is why Nehemiah said in Nehemiah 8:10, the joy of the Lord is my strength. This is the Mount Olive Holy Temple, located temporarily at 7860 Eva Street in Philadelphia, PA 19128. We are so happy that you have chosen to join us this morning. Praise God, praise God. And as we warned you or informed you last week, we want you to help us by reaching out to young girls. So we're asking you to call them up now, they still have time, that they may join in on this service today and receive the information blessing that the Lord has for them in particular. Our program today is as follows. We will have prayer, opening prayer by our own Bishop Simon Phillips. We will then have our scripture read by Deaconess Diana Thompson. Our music today will be given to us by an endeared couple of Mount Olive and of Mount Sinai, and that is none other than our Elder Valerie Purnell and Deacon Michael Purnell. Now, I want to tell you one thing about them. This couple stands victorious over the coronavirus. Let's say amen. Come on, let's say amen. Everyone can say that. These two both stand victorious today in the battle against the coronavirus. So let's say amen, amen. They will come to us first in an organ selection by our Deacon Michael Purnell. Then we will have our announcements. Stay tuned for our announcements. Our flash testimony today, following that flash testimony, and I always say I enjoy flash testimonies, all right? Following that flash testimony, the individual will come back and give us a warning. She's going to give us a warning. Following that warning, we're going to have a special prayer. We're going to have a special prayer because of that warning. We're going to have a special prayer. And that prayer is going to be given to us by Elder Anthony Johnson from the Mount Airy Church of God in Christ. Following that, it's July and we want to celebrate. You know, we like to celebrate our birthdays. And so we will have the July birthdays celebrated following. Then we're going to prepare for the Word of God. And our sermonic selection will be given to us by none other than the Elder Valerie Purnell. Our sermon today will be by our own bishop and pastor, Bishop Thomas Martin. Now, in our invitation, which always follows, I want you to be sure that in responding to the Word today, or responding to the warning today, or responding to the songs today, anything that you want to respond to, you can use that same number that we always use for prayer. For prayer today, you can receive a prayer, you can see information, and you can also receive guidance. So use that same number. Following that, we will have our announcements, and as always, you don't want to miss our announcements because you don't know what's happening unless you hear the announcements. So have a blessed day. God loves you. And let me tell you, I love you too.
Let's pray. Father in heaven, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for just another Lord's day. We thank you, Lord, because we know that you're a God that never fails. You're the same God yesterday, today, and forever. Lord, as we come this morning to hear your word, we ask in the name of Jesus, Lord, to bless our pastor who will bring us the word of God today. We ask you, Lord, to bless everyone that is about to hear the word of God. Remember those who are sick and shut in. Remember those who are unfortunate. Lord, we ask in the name of Jesus, as we go through this day, this new week, we ask you, Lord, to bless us and to keep us from all harm, hurt, and danger. We ask you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, to bless each and every one of us. Remember each member of our congregation. Bless us in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and amen.
I will be reading for your hearing this afternoon, Psalms 107, verse 1-8. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the Redeemer of the Lord say so, whom he has redeemed from the hands of the enemy, and gather them out of the land from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south. They wander in the wilderness in a solitary way. They found no city to dwell in. Hungry and thirsty, their soul fainted in them. Then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them out of their distress. And he led them forth by the right way, that they might go to a city of habitation. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. May the Lord add a blessing to his word.
August the 2nd is our Communion Sunday, and I like to think of it as a In Remembrance of Me Sunday or a Fellowship with Christ Sunday. Please let us enjoy preparing. Joining a bishop today on that Sunday in our Communion Fellowship will be the Elder Anthony Alford from Morningstar Glory Church in New York. He will be also sharing the word with us on that Sunday. So you don't want to miss it. Prepare yourself to commune with Bishop by bringing a glass of grape juice or water, a cracker or a piece of bread, and having prepared yourself by having already read 1 Corinthians 11th chapter, verses 23 to 34. Then on Sunday, August the 9th, we will be once again having a Flash Children's Sunday School under the capable hands of our superintendent, Sister A. Elmira Webb. Don't miss the children. Please keep these announcements in mind and govern yourself accordingly. In your giving, what a blessing it is to be able to give and support the house of the Lord, even in a pandemic. You may do it in three ways. You may mail in your givings to 7860 Eva Street, 19128. Number two, you may give online at www.MountOliveHolyTemple.org. Again, give online at www.MountOliveHolyTemple.org. Or number three, you can download the Givelify app and select Mount Owl. Bless you for your giving. Have a blessed, blessed day.
Born in 1956, I characterize myself as a pioneer. Black family moves to all-white community in Minnesota. Challenges as a young girl and a minority. High school state champion in track and field. Ran track for the University of Minnesota as Title IX battled for equal access for women. Interracial marriage, 3 beautiful children. Life as it unfolded made my heart tender for the hurting and for justice. 24 years working with troubled teen girls. 2007, prophetic word given to me about a ministry for sex trafficked women. God opened my eyes and understanding to victims of sexual exploitation and sex trafficking. Obedience is God's love language. My name is Cynthia Turlough. Dolores Cox's daughter, Bishop Thomas and Sister Carolyn Martin are my aunt and uncle. After working 24 years at this ranch for teen girls with emotional behavioral issues, I came into my Joseph story. It involved false accusations and betrayal by Christian friends. And then in 2016, my husband died after 35 years of marriage. All of this was difficult, but it shaped me to trust God deeper. And it also helped me to see that He was moving me on to what He had ordained for me years before. That is Terebinth Refuge. Terebinth Refuge is a Christ-centered shelter and transitional home that brings hope and healing services to women who have been sexually exploited and trafficked. It uses a model of holistic healing in body, mind, soul, and spirit. In Minnesota, we've done a great work for teens and for children who've been caught in this horrific life. But what God told me is that adult women did not have those opportunities, and He wanted to give that opportunity to these women who by now have all sorts of barriers that make it very difficult for them to even think they're going to get out of this life. Barriers such as drug addiction and criminal records and no skills or way to make money other than what they're doing and being forced to do. The prophetic word I got that said that God would have equal pulling power really resonated with me because I knew that there are best practices for working with these women, but that it was truly God who was going to bring healing. And so with Terebinth Refuge, we want the women to really get an opportunity to discover who God intended them to be and that He would have equal access in bringing that healing power. So in 2018, we opened our doors and the community came alongside of us and built out the lower level of a beautiful home that allowed us to serve 10 beds, 9 women and 1 baby, because we wanted to have a space for a mom and a child. Through all of this, God has opened amazing doors and paved the way in so many miraculous ways. We knew that this house was only temporary, and this year, 2 years later, God had a corporation purchase the house and they're giving it back to us for free, so it is now our permanent location. Another amazing miracle is I've wanted, as part of this vision, to have a social enterprise as part of our employment readiness programming. And so we had a volunteer who had started a small business in her home, and she decided to give us her small business, which will now become our social enterprise. For me, listening to God and obeying what He's calling me to be or to do is the best place to be. This is where there is true joy. Seeing Him heal the lives of these exploited and trafficked women, and to know that is His heart, that He calls us to do justice, to love mercy, and to walk humbly. I am privileged to be able to do this work and to see these lives transformed. God is truly faithful. Thank you. I'd like to give a warning to young people about sex trafficking. Unfortunately, in our country, it is an epidemic and there's sex trafficking happening everywhere. It happens in small towns, it happens in big cities, it's all around us and you don't always see it, but it is happening. And traffickers are looking for youth and for young people. And when I say young people, I do mean boys and girls, although girls happen to be mostly trafficked, but boys are also in this day and age. And what traffickers are looking for are vulnerable youth. Vulnerable meaning that maybe they are depressed, maybe they have anxiety, maybe they have troubles at home and aren't getting along with their parents, maybe they're being bullied in school. And so they're looking for a vulnerability that they can exploit. Sometimes we hear about kids being trafficked, they are picked up off the street, thrown in the trunk of a car and taken off. And although that can happen, but that's not common and that's not how it happens so much in this day and age. What traffickers are doing are perusing all of the social media platforms that young people are on, whether that's Twitter, Snapchat, meeting spaces, whether that's gaming. They're also on gaming in those behind the scene communications that are going on there. Vine. There are many places that they're looking for vulnerable youth. And what they do is they reach out to the youth. They reach out with messages that are first pretty innocent. They have often looked to find out a little about you, whether it's information they gather from a profile that you have that tells them that you are interested in a sport or that you like a certain band or that you have an interest in a certain area. And then they work to exploit that. So they reach out to you and they'll reach out to a number of people and then they'll see who's gonna respond. And so they'll reach out and say, hey, you know, you're really cute or I'm so-and-so. And they might say they're a teenage boy, but in reality they could easily be a 40-year-old man. And they keep that conversation going. And what they do is they build a relationship that they build on trust and helping you to feel you can trust them. And so they're often very kind and caring and really very interested in your interests. And they will ask questions. And so you really have to be careful because these people are looking for someone who they can suck in that way. And then what they will do is eventually arrange a way that you can meet them because by then you have really felt like this is someone you can trust. I've had young people say, yeah, I met someone online and they just were so nice and so kind and they really are the only person who understands me. And in reality, that person could be who knows who. And so you really shouldn't talk to anyone you don't know. That's an important thing. But you also want to be a little paranoid. You don't want to send pictures because they can use those pictures later to really blackmail you. You don't want to, like if you would never walk down a dark alley by yourself in a strange place, in the same way you want to think about being in these chat rooms and giving information to people that you don't know. And so what often happens is they finally find a way to meet you and then you're stuck. Because either they continue grooming you and be that really debonair pimp, Romeo pimp, who gives you gets your nails done, gets clothes for you, gives you a cell phone, or they're the gorilla pimp who immediately starts to beat you and really be aggressive and hurt you and say, you have to do this. Both kind pull you away from people who support you and care about you and get you in a situation where you can't get back to people who really want to help you. So I just am really encouraging young people to think about who they're talking to. If you start to feel uncomfortable with the situation, make sure you talk to an adult, your youth pastor, your parents, whomever you trust, to let them know that someone is pursuing you in this way. You don't want to give out information like where you live or what time you go to sports or any of those things that they can figure out who you are and where you're at. So when you're talking to someone, again, you shouldn't be talking to anyone you don't know. But if you are, you don't want to give them your real name and those kinds of things. So it's very important for young people to be aware that there are traffickers out there looking for opportunities to exploit you in this way and get you in their grips and then to destroy your life.
Good morning, Mount Olive. We thank God for Cynthia Talu and the Terabith Refuge, a shelter for hope and healing. Thank God for the ministry that God has placed into your hands. We pray that you will continue to depend on God to strengthen your hands, to complete the work that He has assigned to you before the foundations of the earth. And because it is that you are working for the kingdom of God and for God's purposes, we have the confidence to know that what you have placed your hands to, you will be successful. So we can praise God for that. In addition to that, we want to continue to pray for our young men. We realize that the enemy seeks to destroy them, to kill and to steal from them. There are many pedophiles that are watching and waiting for the opportunity to take advantage of them also. But we realize today that if the people of God continue to pray, the enemy is and will be defeated. So let us pray. Father, we come in Jesus' name. We thank you for just the opportunity to come boldly before your throne on this morning. We thank you because you have given us the victory. You have made a promise to the people of God that if we pray anything according to your will, it shall be done. And so, God, we can have the confidence to know that what we pray today for our young women and our young men, God, you're going to do it. We pray for wisdom today. God, that you would impart the wisdom of God to teach our young men how to surf the internet properly and safely. That as they are going into chat rooms, God, I pray for the conviction of the Holy Spirit to let them know, God, when danger is lurking around the corner. In the name of Jesus, we pray that even as they are playing the PlayStations, the Maddens, and all of the games, God, that these pedophiles, God, would be defeated. In the name of Jesus, we declare the enemy to be defeated, that all of his plans and his tricks to be revealed, and we cancel them by the power, hallelujah, of the Holy Ghost. We break every chain of the wicked one. We declare and decree, God, that our young men will be victorious in Jesus Christ on this morning. God, we pray, God, that you would continue to protect them throughout the school year and protect them as they walk the streets, as they go back into the school system. In the name of Jesus, God, we decree and declare the blessings of God in their lives, the anointing of God in their lives. We plead the blood of Jesus in Jesus' name, God, that you would cover them. Let no hurt, harm, and danger come upon them. God, release, God, the anointing in their lives to declare the word of God. And we thank you and we praise your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
My name is Jada Early. My birthday was July 13th. I am 8 years old. I am in the third grade. I go to the elementary school. My favorite thing to do is play video games. At my church, I play the drums, sing on the choir, and usher. And I love my church and my pastor, Bishop Martin. Amen.
Hi, I'm Elder Rosemary Newble. My birthday was July 13th. I've been a member of Mount Olive Holy Temple for 19 years. Bishop Martin has been my pastor for 19 years, and it's been 19 wonderful years. My function in the church is I sing on the mass choir, the senior choir, and I'm on the program / communication committee, and I am a missionary. Bishop has taken me to Guyana, South America, to Cuba, to California, and those trips have been just wonderful. Truly, it's been a blessing to be a part of his missionary circle. Bishop has showed me how to be a true missionary. I love my church, I love my pastor and my first lady, and I'm so happy to be a member of Mount Olive Holy Temple. God bless.
Hi, my name is Charles Martinez Jr. My birthday is July 23rd, and I am 9 years old.
What grade in school?
Third.
What's your school?
Alani Elementary.
Any recent recognitions in school?
I know.
Nice. What's your favorite thing to do?
Learn.
What do you do at church?
Learn about God and sing God.
How do you feel about church?
Great.
Wilbur Hunter is better known as Peanut. Was born July the 24th, 1947, which means he is celebrating his 73rd birthday. He has the gift of health. He loves to spontaneously do all as any odd job around the church, inside or outside. He's a real helper in the outreach program. He loves to sit on the front row of services. He is loved by all for his willingness to do. And he loves to sing the praises of God, even if he is off key.
Catherine D. Hornville. I'm a member of Mount Olive Holy Temple. Serve on the Usher's Board. Serve as a deacon as God is very good. He's done many, many things for me. And most recent one is my birthday. Is July 14th. Everyone, I thank you for your birthday wishes. May God bless us all real, real good.
This is the day that the Lord has made. I'm so happy, I'm so glad, because today is my birthday. And I'm grateful to God for the many cards and the videos and the telephone calls. Not only did they come from here, but calls come from Guyana and California and Detroit and so many places wishing me happy birthday. Surprisingly, I didn't realize that I'm now 85 years old. Look how blessed the Lord is to us. He promised to bless our latter days. This is our latter days, and I want to thank everyone, but this was the glorious year of my life. We come this day with thanksgiving. We thank you, Lord, for your glory that thou hast shown upon us. God, we pray today as we look to the hills for what's coming for our help. Lord, that thou will bless this service, thou will send your anointing upon each one that's under the sound of our voice. We thank you, God, in the name of Jesus. Strengthen us, Lord. Grant courage and understanding. Let us know, God, that all that we ask of you, the promise is that you would fulfill it. We thank you, we bless you, we give you the glory. And we thank God today for what to come to you, speaking under the heading of God's forever love. This God is different from man. Every promise that God gives unto us, he don't give it just to give it, but he's fully able. And when we realize that God is a God of love, and he has forever, he exists from the foundation, he will be here in the coming of a return. God's forever love. And today, I want you to look with me into 1 Corinthians chapter 13. And I trust today as we read the Word of God that we might apply it to our hearts. I trust today that we ask God to enlighten our vision. I ask the Lord to help us. And we will not have our desire, but keep us in the center of your will. In 1 Corinthians, the apostle says, though I speak with the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I have become a sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I can remove mountains that have not love, but have not have love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, but have not love, it profit me nothing. And the scripture goes on to tell us that love suffers long. And I think that's one of the important things that we as believers must come to understand in reading the scripture. That not only do we read it, but it's fulfilled within our life. And the manifestation of it gives us the courage,
give us the strength that we might fulfill and overcome. For every promise that God has promised, He brings it to pass. Listen, love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. I'm not concerned about what the other person has that I think it'd be better for me. But the important thing is God, every request that we pray unto you, we pray not only for the world, but for ourselves as individuals. We pray, God, that we understand that we should never envy, but does not parade itself. Is not puffed up. God does not behave rudely. Love, love, love. Keep us in the right spirit. Does not seek its own. Is not provoked. Thinks no evil. You know, sometimes we have a tendency. We ask God for something, He gives it to us. Then we go down. Let's say, for example, when buying clothes, you get asked God for this and for that, and God give it to you. Oh, you're so proud of it. And then if you go outside in the street, you see someone, you come in church, and you see they have the same garment that you have. Oh, my God. It provokes you. But love thinks no evil. It does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Truth is thanking God and thanking and understanding God for His will. For when you pray, pray believing. Love bears all things, believe all things, hope all things, endures all things. But I want you to understand today, it's something about love. When God come into our hearts, for the Bible says, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believe in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that He done for me, He was ridiculed. They turned their back against Him. But He had love from the Father, because the Lord God sent Him into the world, that He might redeem the world from sin, that He might give us hope, that if we ask believing, it shall be done. But love never fails, for wherever there are prophecies, they will fall. Wherever there are tongues, they will cease. Wherever there is knowledge, it will vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect has come, then that which is in part will be done away. But I want you to understand today that God's love is forever. We can speak it. We can believe it. Even though it might be cloudy outside. Even though it might be threatening rain. But the beauty part of it, the love of God, fulfills the saying that sunshine always follow rain. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought like a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, glory, but then I shall know just as I am also known. Now abided, now abided faith, hope, love, these things. Let us remember that love and hope and faith does not make us ashamed. But the greatest of all this is that we have love, because love is what brought Christ into the world. Love is what That's why He asked His Father, let me go down that I might redeem man from the curse. And because of love, we have great assurance that the most important dwelling place, if we're in the will of God, that we will love one another. And I trust today in these few moments that we are speaking that we will understand that's not who we are, but let our faith provide itself to the understanding. Let us rise in the morning with the assurance. Let us have no doubt, because everything is going to be all right. I trust in God, and I found out that there is nobody else that can help us like the Lord do. Oh, weeping may endure for the night, but joy shall come in the morning. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up for the everlasting door, for the King of glory shall come in. And today, by the grace of God, because of his love, we want to realize and to manifest to ever that the love of God is forever. And I pray today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, if you don't know the Lord Jesus in the pardon of your heart, you will cry out, God, give me that love that suffers long. God, give me the love that does not envy. Lord, give me the love that does not parade itself. It's not popped up, it's not behaving unruly, does not seek its own, is not provoked, thinks no evil. It does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoice in the truth. Bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Our childish days are over, Lord. We're now adults. We're now come to the stage of maturity. And I pray, Lord, and in the name of Jesus, bless those who look upon those that are weak in spirit. Pray, God, that thou wilt strengthen them. Bless those that are confined today because of illness. Send forth your healing virtue, Lord, and let this be a time and a season of rejoicing when everything in the country seems to be going the opposite direction. We pray, God, that we stay anchored in the blood, that we will sing the songs of praise. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up the everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. For when you come in and show yourself in our hearts and we portray it to men and women, we can shout with victory that God is love, and thank God that we have the assurance. Bless this day, Lord, and thy people that have listened. Answer every prayer. Help us to sing the songs of praise that we might rejoice for the coming of the Lord. We thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen, amen, amen. Glory to God.
We realize that right now you're not in the brick and mortar of a church building. You may be viewing from a kitchen table or living room, but no matter where your location is, I'm here to let you know Jesus is the answer. No matter what you're going through, the problem, the sickness, the situation, Jesus is your answer. If you don't know him today, it's time to get to know him. He's a prayer away. He said, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart as in the day of provocation. Let this day be the day that salvation comes to your house. Let this day be the day that deliverance comes to you. Don't let it be said too late. God loves you and wants you. He's standing at the door and knocking. Will you let him in? He gave you the best he had when he sent his son. Whatever you're doing right now, I want you to stop, close your eyes, and think about Jesus dying on that old rugged cross for your sins and mine. This isn't just a story we tell at Easter to get you to shout. This is a reality. They crucified him, put nails in his hands and his feet, a crown of thorns on his head. This was all before they had whipped him the night before. He didn't look human. That's how bad they beat him for you and for me. He was on the cross for love. He loves you. He loves me. He died for your sins and mine, but it's not over. He laid down his life for your sins and mine. He's coming back just like he said he would. Accept him while you have the chance. He loves you. He's knocking at the door of your heart. Every knock, he's calling you back to him. Today, accept him. Doesn't matter what you've done or what you're doing. He's calling you by your name. Come home, my son. Come home, my daughter. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Romans 10:9-10 tells us that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. I want you to repeat this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I admit that I am a sinner in need of a Savior, which is you. I believe that you died on the cross for my sins and rose from the dead on the third day, like you said you would. Please come into my heart and be my Lord and my Savior. And then begin to praise him by thanking him for the work that he's just done in your life. Now confess what you just said to someone that's near you right now. And if you don't have anyone near you right now, pick up a phone and call a friend or a relative and tell them that you just accepted the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior. Because as the Bible tells us, for with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. And now welcome into the family of Christ. And we want to hear from you, because this is now the beginning of a brand new life. So won't you please call us at 215-747-1979. Again, that number is 215-747-1979. And we can also share the good news, what Christ has done, and give you additional information. God bless you.
The announcements are as follows. August the 2nd is our Communion Sunday, and I like to think of it as a In Remembrance of Me Sunday or a Fellowship with Christ Sunday. Please let us enjoy preparing. Joining a bishop today on that Sunday in our Communion Fellowship will be the Elder Anthony Alfred from Morning Star Glory Church in New York. He will be also sharing the word with us on that Sunday. So you don't want to miss it. Prepare yourself to commune with Bishop by bringing a glass of grape juice or water, a cracker or a piece of bread, and having prepared yourself by having already read 1 Corinthians 11th chapter, verses 23 to 34. Then on Sunday, August the 9th, we will be once again having a flash children's Sunday school under the capable hands of our superintendent, Sister A. Elmira Webb. Don't miss the children. Please keep these announcements in mind and govern yourself in your giving. What a blessing it is to be able to give and support the house of the Lord, even in a pandemic. You may do it in three ways. You may mail in your givings to 7860 Eva Street, 19128. Number two, you may give online at www.mountolivepolytemple.org. Again, give online at www.mountolivepolytemple.org. Or number three, you can download the Givelify app and select Mount Olive. Bless you for your giving. Have a blessed, blessed day.